Hello there everyone, and welcome back to Nova Aetas. Last time around I was out scouting for seeds, and now I found them. We're gonna go ahead and plant them. And while that grows, which supposedly takes about a week, we're going to go to some of these ruins, especially the ruins in Unxhall, to check out, but apparently there's some good loot there. So, first up, I'm gonna go ahead and collect all the seeds. I've put some tools in here as well, and one of my deeds here for the forest, so I don't lose it. I got a lot of these. I also put some wood down here because I cut some, because I figured, I sort of figured out how the social ranking stuff works. Anyways, last time I didn't really work out how the workbench worked. But apparently there's a character here which you can talk to, and he's just standing there, so you have to look a bit above the bench. But anyways, let's go ahead and talk with him. The farm working bench says, farm working bench. Plant seeds. Which field? Do I have even as much as 4 fields? I thought I only had 3. Anyways, let's plant in field 1. Start. It's complete. Plant seeds. Can I plant in 2? Let's see, do I have 30? No. Okay. So, I've planted 2 of these. Oh, I was 1. I need to get 1 more seed, and then I can plant field 3 as well. And then once we're done, we're using the farming sickle to fix that. I wonder if... it's already glowing. Growing, I say. So I planted my stuff, and it'll take about a week for this to grow. See if we can find 1 more seeds. We can maybe plant another one, field 3. Ah, so yeah, it's hard to see the 4th one, which is sort of behind there. Anyways. Since I figured out a bit more about the social... Okay, wrong button. Is it this? No. This is how we do it. Reports. Personal report. And then character report. So I realized... renown is sort of the battle. What you get from battles and such. And is your battle renown. While prestige is your social standing. And you will get that from... I don't know, well, cutting down trees and stuff in the beginning here, but, you know, the social stuff. I imagine it's something like this, that the guy who made Ligil was planning to do, because there is sort of a social thing there. And basically, you rank this up, and we can go in and through class formation. So, for the first 50 points... you get nothing. You're still a free man, which means that you basically nobody, a throwaway. You don't have any rights and stuff. And then from 50 to 100, you become a farmer. And then beyond, which I am now at 101, and next is 200, I am currently in part of the labor's class, but it's still part of the overall. Lower class. I found like a good overview where you could see all of them, but I can't remember all of it. But yeah, most of this, I got up to 100 just by cutting down trees. You can do that pretty quickly. Each tree you get 3 points. So to do that, to get to 200 would be quite a lot. But anyways. We planted our stuff. It's the 11th of April, 1442, and you know what? We're gonna go this way so we can pass through the towns, and we need just 1 more seed, and then we're gonna go to Unxhall, or the ruins of Unxhall, to check out if there's some good loot to be had. Let's see, all I need. My food is good still, but I will run out pretty soon, so we need to think about that. Quite a lot of deer herds out there. I don't think you get any points for fighting them, though. Could go ahead and join in those battles, but I don't really gain anything from that, so... We can just go to Suno. Looks like they're building up some armored force around here. To go and invade somewhere. One thing that I did notice, however, when it comes to war, is that... The Swadians... have managed to take Veluka. Oh, the Veluka is about maybe to be taken back by the Rodok army, but they managed to take Veluka. I think they did that actually during the last episode. Anyways, oh yeah, the peasant I took with me is now upgraded to a watchman. I'm not sure if I can upgrade him any further. Oh yeah, one thing to note as you level up through the class system. Let's see if I can see that. Personal report. Budget. Is that my tax goes up as well. So if you remember from the start, I paid about 50 dinars of gold in tax. Now I pay 150. And I pay 5 gold for the watchman. So we're gonna go to the ruins of Unxol. We haven't actually found any seeds, so let's see if we can find any seeds here. Or did I was so thorough that I bought all the seeds in the land? Defensive Gambians. Interesting. Gapions. Holy Cross. 30 Tyrell. Tools. Maybe that what we can do next, maybe after that, is to go to the stone quarry and maybe get some... I don't know, stone, I guess? Or just testing out going there and cutting some stone. There's another temple we could go to. Oh, yeah, you know what? There's a ruin here as well. I don't know... There's probably a lot of ruins. There's a great aqueduct over there. Any more interesting stuff? Apparently there's probably plenty of, like, interesting stuff to be found out here as well. But to start off... And since you can't do, like, a super long campaign, I think we will stay for... if we're gonna do... maybe later on, we can do, like, a focus on the colonial business. But for now, we're gonna stay as much as possible here. Anyways, we didn't find any seeds, so let's go to the ruins of Unxol. Here lie the remains of a great town, famous for its walls. Noted for its military reputation. Travelers tell you of a war in the past. Namely, the 13 Years' War, which left Unxol in ruins. In 1276, the Kingdom of Rodoks invaded Svardian lands until they reached the very walls of Unxol. King Harlus II, King Harlus II the Bold, the King Harlus the Bold, the sec. It would really be King Harlus II or the Bold, I guess. But he's the whatever. Was fighting rebels on the banks of the Suder River nearby Harrogoth Castle. When he got notified of the great invasion, it was unfortunately already too late. Unxol had already fallen. But the king immediately mustered forces and went to Vaincourt Castle to prepare for a siege. The siege of Unxol lasted for 2 years. The Rodoks didn't give up. This left Unxol very depopulated and devastated. However, after 2 years, a traitor in the midst opened the gates to the Swadian, and they were able to enter the town. Within a few hours, the town was back in Swadian hands. The Rodoks called for reinforcements, but they too were too late. Just like 2 years, the king was too late. And again, the town of Unxol was under siege by the Rodokians. Technological advances brought new and enormous I thought they were going to say cannons here, but new and enormous trebuchets. These could break down the great walls, but they also destroyed many of the great buildings in town. King Harlus II ordered to open the gate and to send out his best troops, and he would lead them himself from the front. In this battle of the Red Fields, he would find his end, leaving his kingdom in chaos and turmoil. A monument marks the place of his death. His sword, allegedly, is still lost. Many people started a search. Many people would search for this sword, but without luck. Perhaps you can try it. Or is it gone forever? The Rodoks won the battle, but at a high cost. Many Rodok noble knights died in the bitter fighting. Blood colored the battlefield red. And that's why it's called the Red... I think we got that part. The town of Ungsol would pay the price for this bitter, hard fight. Rodok soldiers entered, plundered, and razed the town. After this, the remaining people left their homes and moved to the countryside. Ungsol was no more. Treasure hunters had searched for the sword of King Harlus II for centuries. Stories became myths. Myths became legend, and legends became Zelda. This riddle is mentioned in the same breath as Ungsol. Under a broken bridge you shall go. A tree to your right is all you'll know. From a corner of the ruined city wall, you will get to where the world stalls. To your right will be a patch, which your eye it will catch. A mound you will see unless you're blind. There will be treasure you come to find. Visit the ruins. Okay, so I take it that the mod creator possibly is... English is not his first language, I would say. Some of the stuff I think could have been worded better. I don't know why I pick up on that in such a manner, but yeah. I think since the mod like has so much immersion and stuff, it feels like a little bit left out when it feels like it's sort of a high school thing that's been written in some of the things. Anyways, it's the broken bridge, I imagine. So we need to go through it, I think it was. Then it's the corner of the wall and something, a tree I will see. You know what? I'm not sure if it's so obvious as to just because we've got what looks to be a statue and some bushes around. Could it be so simple as to find the treasure down here, or am I gonna have to go into town? So I imagine this is a shrine that has been erected in the memory of Harlus the Bold. So let's see. Would there be any treasure around here? There's a mound. We've got a small mound out there. Could it be something out here? No, can't really see anything here. A lot of flowers and crap. Wait a minute. What's that? You know what? There's a chest here, but it looks like a sword. Ah, here he is. King Harlus the Second's sword. It's a two-handed, one-handed sword. It's got 37 swing and 32 thrust, which is better than my sword. My heavy bastard sword, so I can go ahead and get rid of that. Jesus Christ, the selling price on this. Silver ore, pottery, oil. Nice. Thank you, good king. I stole your sword. Right, now going into this place and searching for, because I think you maybe missed it in the beginning, but down in the corner it says that four chests are here. I wonder if this sword is one of them, but there is, I guess, more chests inside here. I know of one, because I remember that I test played this a long time ago, and I think, hopefully, that I can remember where that chest is. And it should be next to the church, to the right of the church. But then if there's two, or maybe three chests more, I'm probably gonna have to take quite a while to find them. Yes, next to the church. Right next to you here, these piles of rubbles. And, just as I recall, I don't know. You know what? We'll take the stones anyways. So there might be a few more chests, and I'll probably have to take quite some time. It's gonna be unnecessary for me to just run around this place trying to figure out where, because this looks to be a rather large place to search through. So I'll go ahead and cut, and then we'll see what I found. I found one more chest, and it's just by the entrance. So from the broken bridge, and you go straight through here, and boom. Salt and a pile of coins. Now, where could the next one be? Okay, so here we are for the final treasury chest, which is sort of in between. That's the corner tower and that one, and sort of in between there next to this big tree-ish. Or maybe what the easiest point would be right across from the church. If you go from the door right towards here, you will go ahead and find this one. Raw silk, war darts, and some coins. So I think those are all the chests to be discovered. I'm not sure, but I think so. And let's go to the marketplace and sell them. So, war darts, don't really need them. Few coins, raw silk. I want to make sure there's no raw silk in town so we can sell it. Same with salt. Bloody stones. There is a bit of oil. The coins, a few coins, pile of coins. I mean, they're only worth, or I can only sell them for about 10% of their actual price, which is not. Pottery, we're not going to sell here because there's a lot of pottery in town. A silver ore, I guess I can sell the coins. But I think the oils and the pottery we'll keep, and then we'll sell them some other place. So we got 2,000, which is still pretty good. Let's go back to Suno. Or maybe we should take this way back there, because there are some ruins next to the papal see. Ah, crap. I'm Henry. We are followers of Christianity. That is the one true faith. We will leave you in peace, fellow friend. May the Lord be with you. Thank you. May the Lord of the Old and the New Testament be with you. Let us now separate our ways. Indeed, fellow. Wait a minute. Lord of the Old Testament. But don't you know that's Satan? He's the creator of the world. The God of the New Testament is the right one. I knew you are an infidel. Fight or die. You must be sacrificed for heaven. Oh my God. Oh my goodness. Oh crap, there's 15 of them. Watchmen! Charge! There's... Oh crap. Oh, he's... Wait. Are you running away? I thought he was running away. Oh crap. There's no way I'm gonna be able to fight these, am I? Oh, they cut him through and then just continue on riding after me. Oh, my master. This is not gonna go well, is it? Oh, shit. Oh, they're all mounted. I think. No, 15. That means that there's someone on foot as well. I'm not even hitting these bastards. Oh, yeah, here's another group. Oh, my God. Where did all these bastards come from? And I am Christian. Apparently not Christian enough. I need to read the Bible or something. So I know how to not be attacked by these people. How could I... Why did I say the New and the Old Testament? The God of the... Apparently he's Satan. Or maybe you're not supposed to... be able to get away from them that way. Maybe I need to pray a bit more. Because I got like piety from praying. So maybe that's the key. I wish if I... if I could win this... I imagine the loot, but at the same time... I haven't taken a single one of them down yet. You know what? This is probably going to take a while. You probably don't want to see all of it. So, I'll get back once I've sort of tried my best, as it were. I am quite amazed that I actually might be able to do it. Let's see, does this work? Can I do this way? Let's see, do I get new balls? No, I don't. Damn it. Otherwise, you usually can do it like that to get new balls. Anyways, I was able to cut down quite a few of them. And you can see I cut them off their horses as well. It's down to the sword, really. Oh, damn it. That could have been nasty. They have hit me quite badly as well. But I must say, this took a while. They seem to be less likely to try to block when I come in with a stab. This guy is not even looking at me. And... he almost killed me. Am I gonna be able to do this? Or are they gonna steal my shit? There's only two of them left. I can do this. 8 damage. Oh shit, my horse! Get up! Oh shit. Why can I not do... Why am I only doing stabs? Stabs not gonna be that useful when I'm on foot. Oh shit, this is not gonna work. No, damn it! Oh, I was so close! Why was I... Oh, I would have done up stabs and shit. Damn it. There's only two of them left. They took 500 gold. And my heavy bastards. But there's only two of them. So once... Come on. Let me flee from captivity. And I will slay these fools. Fully health. You know what? I will give you nothing but cold steel, you utter scum. You know what? I could have used my battle abilities maybe to heal myself. I do have a little bit of... what's it called? First aid. I'm gonna revenge... My watchman, that you slain, you dastardly bastards, victory will be mine, and you will give me back my sword. Oh, that one I missed. I fired through his head. Come on. And it would have been nicer if I cleanly just kill down those 15, but this will do. We got low. I'll take these two peasant women. Cavalry boots and a bastard sword. Is that all I got? Well, I got a level as well. I got a level from killing them. And we sort of found out this castle over there. But, I mean, I don't think... attacking them at their castle is probably not going to go so well. Oh, there's more of them. Let's see. The 11th was the day in which I left. You know what? Maybe oils are plentiful here. Something that isn't... Ah! One seed! Just what I need. Pottery, however... They had one piece of pottery before. How about some cavalry boots? Am I going to sell the sword or am I going to give it to... Let's see if we can find a companion. So far I haven't really... Maybe I should get a companion and start building up... building up like an army. Oh, I thought almost the hired blade was going to fight me there. I don't know what happened. I also wish, really, to... there hasn't gone a week, so we can't go ahead and... let's see. Goods. Do they have a lot of... They have no oil here. Oil pe... Ooh, look at the price! That's why you should wait. I could sell... I don't remember what I could sell the oil for, but look here. Here I can sell it for a lot more. So I got 700. Let's go back to my farm and we can plant one more field. And then maybe what I'll do is I'll cut back to when I'm able to harvest this. Let's go open the chest. We need the other seeds. And then workbench. Hello there, Mr. Workbench. I want to plant field 3. Complete. So, we've got 3 fields now that are slowly growing, and I will be able to harvest this. There'll be a lot, and then I can make that into flour, and maybe I can make that into bread. I don't know. I don't know exactly how this works, but we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out. Looking at the time, though, this is gonna have to end right here. So, hopefully, you guys enjoyed this. And hopefully, I'll see you guys for the next one. Bye!